Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our 7:30 a.m. worship service here in Cathedral of Praise. We want to greet everyone a happy Easter Sunday. So may we request everybody, please, in all our campuses and our branches and those watching us online to please do stand up, and we're going to start our service in prayer. The focus of our prayer is for us to be effective witnesses for the gospel. So COP, how do we pray?
Fervently and with joy.
Let's lift the name of Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Father in heaven, we are thankful, O God, and grateful for your privilege, O God, that we are bearers of the good news of Christ. Thank you, Jesus, that we can preach the gospel. And Lord, we know, God, it is the power of God Almighty to transform lives. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, because you are good, and your goodness leads men to repentance, O God. You bring us, O God, into your presence. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, for you are so good, O God. You never leave us nor forsake us. Thank you, Jesus, for pouring out the goodness of the Lord in our lives, pouring out so much good upon us, changing our lives. And thank you for the hope of the resurrection, Lord, that there can be new life given to us, that we can be renewed, we can be transformed by you, Jesus. Thank you, for you are the way, the truth, and the life. Thank you, Jesus, that we have access to our Heavenly Father because of you, Jesus. You made a way for us, Lord, even though it's impossible to change, you help us, oh God, to be saved, to be changed, God. Oh, we thank you, Lord. Lord, right now we pray for your will be done upon our lives. We pray for salvation to come to our families, to our loved ones, God, to the schools, the workplaces, the government. Lord, we pray, Jesus, that we claim of the promise that our family will be saved. Lord, as we believe in the Lord Jesus, we will be saved. Also, our household. We thank you, Jesus, for all your promises are yes. Lord, we ask that you let us hear you say, oh God, that our family will be saved. And Lord, we pray that we'll be aligned in our campuses, in our offices, that people will turn to you as they see us. People will turn to you, oh God, as they see the light in us. Lord, we pray, oh God, that you'll grant us opportunities to share the gospel in the campuses, oh, in offices, in the business of your people. We pray, oh God, people, oh God, will know you, God. You've given us an opportunity. And Lord, let your Holy Spirit enable us to become witnesses. Thank you, Jesus, for it is you who gives us the ability, the power to preach the gospel. Lord, we honor you, God. We thank you, Lord, for you are faithful, who made a promise. And Lord, we are praying for more opportunities for our goal groups to open. Lord, in Maui, God, in Bacolod, we are praying that the gospel will be expanded in those places. More goal groups will be opened. More people, God, who will get water baptized. More people will be filled with the Holy Ghost, overflowing with the Holy Ghost. We thank you, Jesus. Let your goodness, oh God, lead men to repentance, changing us, oh God, working in our lives, working in our hearts. Thank you, Jesus. And Lord, we are praying, oh God, to you, for you are the Lord of the harvest. Lord, we are praying for you will send more workers in the harvest field. We're praying, oh God, for more pastors, for more leaders, oh God. We thank you, Jesus, oh God, we'll be able to open more branches, more churches, more campuses, more satellites all across, oh God, our nation, and even, oh God, all throughout the world. We thank you, Jesus, for you'll be able to become a springboard of nation. Lord, and people will know you, Jesus, so we can reach out to those who are lost. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, as you continue to use us, accompany the message with miracles, signs, and wonders. Lord, as we pray for people, Lord, we pray that they will know you, God, because you will confirm your word with miracles, signs, and wonders. Let there be mighty healings taking place. Cancer be disappeared, oh God. We thank you, Jesus, for your goodness. In Jesus' name.
Jesus is the light of this world, and the unfolding of his word gives light. Jesus is the Christ.
Yes.
Not a way, a truth, and one way of life.
What a joy! What a blessing to be in the house of the Lord! Welcome to Cathedral of Praise!
At COP, we know that like the apostles, we are to preach the gospel publicly and from house to house. It is a privilege to be in your homes sharing the gospel.
Amen.
At COP, we know a pastor is to teach the word of God, enabling us to live lives that please the Lord.
Amen.
At COP, we know we are to preach the gospel to the poor, bringing them to what Jesus called life and life more abundantly.
Amen.
At COP, we heal the sick in Jesus' name, and our God is with us even to the end of the age.
Amen.
At COP, we know that the message is the gospel. We love it, we live it, and we preach it. It is the good news, and it is the power of God unto salvation for those who believe.
Amen.
At COP, our eyes are on Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. We don't worship worship. We don't worship fellowship. We worship Jesus.
Amen.
At COP, we know that we have been called by God to be priests. We are to serve Him. We don't live in our own little world. We serve Him fervently until every lost person is found. We will build 200 churches across our land and across the world in the next 20 years.
Amen.
At COP, we know every member has been given the Great Commission, so we joyfully work while it is yet day, seeing people born again, baptized in water, baptized in the Holy Spirit, and learning to live for God.
Amen.
At COP, we know that we are to bear fruit and not to gather fruit. There is no shortage of people that need to hear the gospel. Our joy is to go to the harvest field and then bring the harvest field to the Lord.
Amen.
At COP, we know we are to fill His house with His praise. We praise the Lord. We praise Him for who He is and what He does. If it's not about Him, it's not praise.
Amen.
At COP, we know that the tithe is not about obedience to the law. It is before the law, during the law, and even Jesus taught tithing. It is our joy to bring the whole tithe into the storehouse to the Lord.
Amen.
At COP, we know prosperity is about trusting our Heavenly Father for everything we need. No fear of debt, no fear of poverty, no fear of people. Our Father is our provider.
Amen.
At COP, we know that Jesus taught us to pray our Father. That means that we are part of a great family of God across this world. When one part of that family needs help, it is our role freely give as we have freely received.
Amen.
We know God's grace abounds to us, teaching us to say no to sin and to work hard for Him.
Amen. We worship You, Jesus. Hallelujah. We glorify You, Lord. We rejoice in Your presence. Thank You, Jesus.
We say, I will do everything.
Let's worship the Lord.
good morning, everyone, and welcome to our 7:30 a.m. worship service here in Cathedral of Praise. What a happy Easter Sunday, and it's wonderful to be in the house of the Lord. We want to greet all our first-timers and those watching us online, all our campuses, and all our branches. Thank you for allowing us to be part of your life this Sunday morning. Here at CUB, we do believe that we have a God who answers prayers. Amen. So if you are here and if you are in need of any prayers, please, please do feel free to come down here in front in all our campuses. And also, if you're there at the main campus balcony, please come forward in the center aisle and our pastors will meet you there. So CUB, let me ask you this wonderful question. Are you ready to worship our wonderful God?
Amen.
Let's worship the Lord. Yes.
The solid rock I stand, but by the grace of God.
Hey!
Celebrating our communion. May I ask our amazing ushers to please serve those who have not yet received their emblem. As always, we remember what Jesus had done on the cross for us, for our salvation, and for our healing. Let me read to you 1 Corinthians chapter 11, beginning with verse 23. For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us pray. This bread
represents
the body of my Savior,
the body of my Savior,
Jesus Christ, that was broken for me. He took the pain,
bore my sufferings,
and by his wound,
I am healed.
Let us partake of. In the same way, also he took the cup and after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Let us pray. This cup represents the blood of Jesus that was shed for me.
His blood.
Wash away all my sin.
Erase
my past. Guilt. And shame.
I am now clean.
Pure.
Sanctified.
And justified.
Just as if I have never sinned.
I remember this now. In Jesus' name.
Savior, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Savior, he can move the
focus our attention for this week at COP, followed by Pastor Sumrall's offering teaching.
This week at COP, School of the Cross was Good Friday, and what a Good Friday it was indeed. We started the day with a well-attended morning prayer from 5:30 to 7 a.m., followed by Pastor Sumrall's world-class master's-level teaching from 9 a.m. until afternoon, and ending the incredible day with a meaningful communion together. As always, the Israel Museum artifacts were a big hit with the members, and the teaching was unforgettable. How thankful we are for the sacrifice of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Stand, be brave, strip, stand by God.
This week at COP, CAD held the annual Praise Drills, testing the ministry skills of all ministries, from dancers to musicians to choirs in all campuses. Starting with a colorful parade and worship, skill games were held all over main campus all day Thursday. Besides the 10 campuses, we had the participation of four branches: Lipa, Bataan, Batangas, and Olongapo. What a loud, joyful, noisy, wonderful day. Sao has taken the trophy for 3 years in a row. Who could take it from South this year? Well, this year, our winning alliance for the first time was Cathedral Choir. Congratulations. This week at COP, our men had their first Man Up gathering for 2024 with Pastor Sumrall in the main river room teaching on consistency. The guys held Man Up Ranger consistent challenges with the following winners. Archery was won by Joe Padilla. Toss challenge, Xerxes and Arnell from Kawi. And the weightlifting challenge was won by Ari Sleko. Next Man Up gathering will be June 15 with Pastor Jamie Widener. This week at COP, we had the most wonderful Share Life Sunday at main campus last Sunday. Luke's Call medical professionals worked hand in hand with the Philippine Blood Bank, seeing many of their volunteer students saved. COP, 105 of you volunteered to donate blood, and of that number, 90 were successful donors. Luke's Call, we're so proud of you, thankful for all you do, and looking forward to the next Share Life Sunday. This week at COP, our Luke's Call medical professionals also held a medical outreach in Maipaho, Caloocan City. 50 senior citizens availed of free medical consultation and some tests. This week at COP, let's give all the glory to God for the harvests our brothers and sisters have dedicated to the Lord. Ramil and Lorna dedicated their Nissan Navara Caliber X. The Estocada family dedicated their dream house in Naik along with three motorcycles. Christelle and Tim of East Campus regularly attend morning prayer with a request for provision for their dream house construction. God completely surprised them with blessings and bonuses, and now they praise God for their debt-free construction, completion, and dedication of their home. Arnell and Tess of Kawi dedicated their newly acquired house and lot to be rented as a business income. Five neighbors were saved at the dedication. Bulacan's Ignacio family rejoices in the dedication of their house and lot. Also from Bulacan, Roy and Sherry dedicated their house and lot to the Lord. From our Mission School group in Oregon, the Barcenas couple dedicated their Toyota Corolla Cross Hybrid. The Catabas family dedicated their house and lot and additional lot to the Lord. They praise God for this harvest from the precious seed. They will no longer rent because now they are homeowners. Monette Maniago from Joy in the House Choir Kawi dedicated their new business to the Lord, and six people were saved. The Chu family dedicated their nail and wellness spa business. The Plarisan family of East praised God for their Montero and three trucks dedicated for their business. Bulacan Salvador family dedicated their Mitsubishi Strada GLS. And Felicitas Sevilla praises God for the dedication of her food business. This week at COP, rejoicing with heaven's angels for souls being saved. Wired Maine conducted workplace evangelism both in person and on Zoom, seeing 31 professionals saved. From COP San Pablo, 107 were saved through harvest visits, street evangelism, and school outreach. COP Romblon saw 50 respond to the message of Jesus in a high school outreach and house-to-house evangelism. COP Singapore did harvest visits, seeing 7 saved. Cathedral Choir reached out in Tondo with a community crusade, seeing 35 saved. CCE, or Cathedral Choir, has also seen 226 decisions for Christ this year in their weekly outreach at the Dolomite Beach. The Mighty Men in Uniform saw 207 Army applicants give their hearts to Christ. Maine Wired Pros are so thankful after much prayer and as a result of COP members dedicating their newly renovated office at World Health Organization. Wired was given the opportunity to share the gospel there, and 37 people were saved. Coming up at COP, let's look forward to a refreshing April with overnight prayer, April 12 Friday running through 4 a.m. April 13 Saturday. Overnight prayer is held in all campuses and joined together with live feed. Finally, coming up at COP, iServe Weekend is the last weekend of April. At COP, we are all busy serving the Lord. If you're not yet ministry involved, this special weekend will help you decide where you can plug in. It has been another great week at COP.
We had a wonderful School of the Cross yesterday. Thank you so much for allowing Sister Bev and I to be a part of your life on a day like no other in history, a day in which the whole world changed. It's a beautiful thing to just set aside this day every year, and rather than use it as a holiday, use it as a day to remember, where we rebuild the foundations of what it means that Jesus died on a cross for us. I kept teaching you yesterday that so many people, they know what Jesus did, but they don't know why he did it, and they don't know what it accomplished. And what is the point in knowing the facts if you don't know the wisdom that goes with it? Now, one of the things that happened during that first Holy Week was a beautiful offering that was given to Jesus by a woman with the alabaster vial. We find the story in Matthew chapter 26, beginning with verse 6. Now, when Jesus was at Bethany in the house of Simon the leper, a woman came up to him with an alabaster flask of very expensive ointment, and she poured it on his head as he reclined at table. And when the disciples saw it, they were indignant, saying, "Why this waste? For this could have been sold for a large sum and given to the poor." But Jesus, aware of this, said to them, "Why do you trouble the woman? For she's done a beautiful thing to me. For you will always have the poor with you, but you will not always have me. In pouring this ointment on my body, she has done it to prepare me for burial. Truly I say to you, wherever the gospel is proclaimed in the whole world, what she has done will be told in memory of her." Then one of the 12, whose name was Judas Iscariot, went out and betrayed him. The beautiful gift and the correction that came because of it was the trigger of Judas's betrayal. But rather than look at the negative side of it, I want you to see a couple of beautiful truths. Number one, this occurred on the Tuesday night. Jesus went out every night during that first Holy Week, every night after Crusades, all day, so to speak, in the temple courts. Every night he went out to Bethany, about 3 kilometers outside the town, and that's where he spent the night and would come back in the next day. On the Tuesday night is when these events occurred. And just think of it for a moment. I call this the gift that kept on giving. She poured this beautiful ointment on his head, on his hair. That would have been smelling beautiful all night Tuesday night, all night Wednesday night, all day Thursday and Thursday night, right through his arrest on Thursday night, all night long when he was in that stinky dungeon, waiting his legal trial the next morning, and even Friday, as he was beaten and scourged and put on a cross, that beautiful fragrance was there. And to just think how that woman must have felt, that she was able to be used of God to do such a beautiful thing for Jesus that would have comforted him through that entire week and through all of those difficulties. And then, beloved, apply that to your life. How many times does God give a beautiful gift to you? A gift that keeps on giving. A gift that every time you look at it, every time you sit in it, every time you lay down on it or whatever, every time you sit there and you remember, look how much the Father loves me. But now there's another side to this story, and it's not nice. And that side is the giver and the thief. If you put this passage together with the other Gospels, you see that the criticism began with Judas. And Judas started a chorus of criticism, even among those who love Jesus, against him receiving this beautiful gift. They called it a waste. and against the giver of the gift, as if they have any right to say anything about what this woman does with her own property. But they shot their mouth off, and they all joined together in this chorus of criticism started by Judas the thief. Beloved, be very careful when you join the criticisms of other people's blessings. You have no idea what it means to that person. They had no idea what this meant to Jesus. They should have. He told them how many times he was going to be murdered and killed. But they had no idea what this meant to Jesus. But they criticized him anyway. And they tried to destroy the generosity of this woman's heart. But Jesus, number one, would not bow to their criticism. He corrected them for their criticism. And he said, you know what? Not only am I not ashamed of this, I'm going to make sure that this woman's story is told every place the gospel is preached. I am proud to have received this gift from this woman, and I am proud of this woman's generosity, and the story shall be told wherever the gospel is preached. Now I look at that and I go, you know what? I want to be like that woman. I want to give gifts that will so bless the kingdom, that Jesus so wants to bless the kingdom, that wherever the gospel is preached, the story of our generosity is told. Beloved, let's not be like Judas the thief. Let's not be like the apostles that criticized. Let's be like the woman that gave. All right, that's my offering thought today. We've got a great musical with the kids, and I have to tape this. I can't do this live because I am told that this is the first year that all 10 campuses will be having a live musical with their kids. What a development. What blessing upon our Christian arts department. What blessing upon our children's ministry that we can have 10 different musicals going on in the city at one time. I'm so proud of CAD. I'm so proud of our parents. They're patiently waiting for the kids, and I'm so proud of all of the kids. All right, put your tithe in the red envelopes today. Put your seed in the blue envelopes. If you have remain funds, put those in the green envelopes as we build God's house, and come. Bring your tithe and seed before the Lord.
We request everybody to please do stand up, and let's ask our wonderful ushers to please do help us out, and let's stretch forward our hands towards His tithe and RC. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we come before you in Jesus' name. We are thankful for the opportunity, O God, to bring our seed, O God. And Lord, we return to you the tithe that belongs to you. Lord, we know, God, you will throw open the floodgates of heaven upon our lives, O God, and pour out so much blessings upon the businesses, upon the careers of your people. Lord, we pray, O God, for abundant harvest flowing in the lives of your people. And Lord, as we bring to you our seed, may return back to us, O God, 30, 60, and 100-fold, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Bless all the works of our hands. Lord, cause increase, promotion, O God, and more sales upon your people. And Lord, provide, O God, for more seed to sow and bread for food. Lord, we honor you and we praise you, God, for you are wonderful. Thank you, Jesus. Receive all this. Receive our worship. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Please be seated in all our campuses and our branches.
Good morning, everyone. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. That is the message of this musical that our kids have been working on since the beginning of this year. Thank you, parents. Thank you, kids, for your hard work and your heart work. So may we ask everybody to please open your hearts, open your minds, and enjoy this musical. Let's dive in at Splash Kingdom!
These colors don't work for you. Shelly, what do you think of her outfit?
Sandy's right. Those aren't your colors. And why don't you put the shade of makeup?
I think that looks better.
Let me take a look at you. Wait, what are you doing here without your bra?
Hi, everyone. Did I hear someone call for my name?
Tanner, what is Star doing here?
Look, I had to bring her. My mom made me.
Hey, what are you talking about? Tell me, I wanna know. Relax. Let's just start the stuff we came here for so we can have fun!
Woo! Come on, everyone. It's time to dive into Splash Kingdom!
That's right. Grab your goggles and your sunscreen and join us at the best water park in the land!
Under our arms.
Shore, and Shelly Bubbles, and all of our friends totally here at Splash Kingdom. Awesome!
Hey, let's go catch a wave and ride that curl.
Why? If it isn't Dewdrop, the best surfer anywhere.
Dewdrop's the name, and surfing's my game.
I don't know about y'all, but I've been waiting for this day all year. We almost had to go to that other water park. You know, the one that's terribly hot.
Hi, everyone. Sorry I'm a little late. I had to make a quick stop by the bank to get some spending money for a trip. The first ride's on me. Tanner Seafish. Ah, Splash Kingdom. Truly a wonderful sight, even to a blue blood. I, Tanner Seafish, am ready to rumble.
Tanner, you look more like you're ready to stumble. What's the deal with all these swim attire, Tanner? You look like a walking toy display.
As usual.
Well, I made a quick stop to the Goose Dance department store and picked up a few items that could assist me in my day at Splash Kingdom. For the Seafish family, first class is the only way.
That's my brother.
Really, Tanner? Could it be that
you're just afraid of the water?
Well, he did have that incident last year. Remember?
Ouch, dude. No more diving for centaurs in a wading pool.
Look, everyone. It's past 10 o'clock. And the gate is still closed.
Hey, open up. Let us in.
Yeah, let us in.
Wait. I, Tanner Seafish, will use my influence with the management to rectify the situation. Hello? Let us in.
Some influence. Look, there is a lifeguard. Maybe he can help. Excuse us, sir.
Can I help you?
We're all ready to have a day of fun at Splash Kingdom.
Great. We'll be glad to have you. I'm Peter, the supervising lifeguard in charge of the front gate. And this is my assistant, Gabriel, and our fine Splash Kingdom team of lifeguards. We run the day watch shift right here at Splash Kingdom.
Okay, whatever. Cut the introduction. So, what's with the gate? Shouldn't it be open by now?
Yeah!
Well, do you have a reservation?
Guys, have you ever heard of needing a reservation to, like, enter a water park? Duh!
Yeah, duh!
Radical! My mom keeps saying she has a reservation about me. Does that count, Pete?
No. This reservation had to be made personally with our chief executive officer, Jesus Christ.
I am Tanner Seafish of the Seafish family, and I always have a standing reservation.
Yeah, that's my brother.
No one has a standing reservation here at Splash Kingdom. There's only one way to enter. Your name must be found in our reservation book. We call it our Book of Life.
Great. Now we're talking. I'm sure you'll find my name.
My name will be there. I'm the cutest. Check Starfish.
I'm sorry, ma'am. Your name is not on the list.
Aww. Tanner Seafish is on all the finest registries. Don't worry, everyone. My name talks. I'll have us in this gate in no time.
Tanner Seafish. No, sorry, sir. I don't see Tanner Seafish listed.
What? There must be some mistake. How rude.
Okay, move aside, Tanner. Like, I'm Sandy Shore. Gabe, could you, like, surf through the pages for my name?
No, I'm sorry.
Like, bummer.
How about me? I'm Shelly Bubbles. Do you see my little name?
Sure thing. Let's see. Betty Bubbles, Candy Bubbles, Sherry Bubbles, Tiny Bubbles. Sorry, no Shelly Bubbles listed.
Aww. How distressing!
Hi, I am...
Dorothy?
That's right, I'm Dorothy. But I seem to recall that at some point in my life people call me Didi. Do you see my name on the list? two D's, Didi.
Sorry, no Dorothy and no Didi.
Do you see the name Rain Wave?
Sorry, no waves.
Okay, dude, do you eyeball the name Dewdrop?
Yes, I see some drops. There's a Daisy drop and a Dudley drop.
Cool, dude. They're my grandparents.
But again, I am sorry to say, I see no Dewdrop.
Aww.
Oh my gosh. We are sorry. You simply cannot get in without a reservation.
But why? I really have a nice voice. If I sing, can you let us in? Mommy, 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 ma!
Well, I'm sorry. No works program can get you in either.
This is unbelievable. Who's the CEO, Jesus Christ? My dad works with every top executive officer in the country. He must know my dad.
Yeah!
My boss knows everyone. But do you know him? That's the question.
Hey, like, couldn't you look one more time?
I'd be glad to check again. But if your name is not in the Book of Life, you may not enter. I'm sorry, no exceptions.
I'll take another look inside our golden book of life. I'll gladly check again to make quite sure that I am right.
No, I'm afraid your name is absent. Nowhere to be seen.
To enter, you must know our Master Jesus Christ the King.
Maybe our life-saving team can help.
Shut up.
thank you for sharing such a great history lesson with us all.
It was beautiful.
But we don't have all day.
Let me try another angle. I'm sure my platinum card might help. Come on, name your price. Money's no object when you're dealing with a fish.
Well, that's the funny thing about Splash Kingdom. The admission's free. Someone paid for your admission many years ago.
Come on, money talks.
Money is silent at the gates of Splash Kingdom. To enter, you must be certified by passing Life-Saving 101. That, and only that, will get you to see my boss and open the gate. You see, he is the gate. You can only enter through him.
Okay, if passing this Life-Saving 101 gig will get us in, let's give it a ride.
Yeah.
Life-Saving 101 has three basic steps to certification. You must...
A. Admit that you have sinned. B. Believe God loves you and sends his son and our CEO Jesus to save you from your sin.
And
C. Claim Jesus as your own personal Lord and Savior.
You might call this class the ABCs to salvation.
Summertime. Hey, Pete, why do you really need a lifeguard? This dude's a great swimmer. I swim like a fish. No pun intended.
Well, I, Tennessee Fish, am also an excellent swimmer.
Your only problem is that you have to hide your nose when you swim.
Well, Life-Saving 101 teaches us to swim in living water. Lifeguard team, come show us the plan.
If you ask me what it takes to become certified, to get a pass through the gate so you don't have to wait, I will tell you what to do and make it very clear. So pay attention, you'll hear what it takes to be certified.
My boss has provided a great textbook to guide you as you learn.
I read the Times and Wall Street Journal, but I don't believe I've ever seen this book.
This is the Bible.
Like, look at all those tiny words.
This is almost as long as Florante at Laura.
Dude, my grandparents were always reading the Bible. Granny knew scripture for everything. In fact, every time this surfer dude got out of line, she had me copying those Ten Commandments.
Okay, we got a textbook. Time is ticking away.
You're right about that. Many people miss Splash Kingdom simply by putting off their certification. Let's begin. A, admit you have sinned. Gabriel, can you open to Romans 3:23 in our textbook?
Yes, sir. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Sin? Like S-I-N. Sin. Like what is sin?
Sin is something that you do that is against God.
I doubt I've ever sinned. I attended an international school, you know.
Everyone sins. Everyone needs to be forgiven. Think about it. Have you ever looked at someone's test at school? Or took something that wasn't yours? At that moment, you were guilty of sin.
Kingdom.
Same. It's like whenever I try to do things right, things just go wrong. Bummer.
Hey, I'm the guilty one. It's tough keeping the surfer dude's head straight.
When you think about it, I guess even a fish makes mistakes from time to time.
Great. You have all passed the first step. You have admitted to your sin. You are now ready for the second step. B, believe God loves you and sent His Son Jesus to save you from your sin. I mean, just look at Tanner. He has all that swimming gear to keep him safe.
I'm not afraid. A fish is just simply always prepared.
Come on, Tanner. Cuff it up. What's with the water wings?
Okay. I guess I'm really wearing all this life-saving gear because I'm afraid something bad might happen to me.
See? Everyone has something to be afraid of. But the great thing about fear is that Jesus came to take our fears, if we just believe in Him. Gabriel, can you open to John 3:16 in our textbook?
For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life.
What's left, Peter?
The final step to life-saving 101 is C. Claim Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Gabriel, can you open to Romans 10:16 in our textbook?
Radical, Gabe. Let your fingers do your walking for you.
Romans 10:13 says, everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved.
So do you mean to tell me that all I have to do is ask and this Jesus dude will come?
Yes, Dee, and He will open the gate. He wants everyone to enter Splash Kingdom, the rich, the poor, the weak, and the strong. Jesus is the living water that saves us.
Am I, Tanner Sea Fish, welcome to swim in this water?
Sure thing, Tanner. Just ask and you will receive.
Around me, let it see.
Congratulations! You have all passed Life-Saving 101 and are now certified!
Gabriel, how about checking to see if our names are in the Book of Life now?
Sure thing, let's see. Shelly Bubbles, there it is. Sandy Shore, yes, it's also here.
Yes, we did!
Hey, how about checking for my name, Gabe?
Yes, I see it right there between Daisy Drop and Dudley Ice Drop.
Cool, Pete. I can't wait to tell my granny.
Hey, Gabe, remember me? Dee Dee.
A definite yes.
Is my name there?
Yes.
Wait. How about me? Do you see them, Wayne?
Clearly, yes.
Wait a minute. What about me? I don't suppose you see a Tennessee fish on that list, right?
Sure do, Tanner.
Cool. Hey, everyone. I'm not afraid anymore. I think I might even lose these water wings.
Like, cool, Tanner. I'm proud of you. To be honest, you look like a bubble in all those stuff.
Our textbook says in Proverbs 18, verse 4, the words of a man's mouth are deep waters, but the fountain of wisdom is a bubbling brook.
That's just how I feel inside. I'm bubbling with joy.
Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Before I knew it, I was lost and alone. The life in heaven I had long before became bewildered, wanted change in my life, but nothing.
Certified and are now ready to enter Splash Kingdom. Gabriel, open the gate.
There's so many rides, I don't know what to ride first.
I think I might surf down Eternal Life Mountain.
Gee, that sounds so cool.
I might ride the rafter I ride.
I'm heading straight to Forever Falls.
I know where me and my sister's going. We're going to ride on that wave of life. Come on, let's go.
Join us at Splash Kingdom. The certification is easy. A, admit you have sinned. B, believe God loves you and sent his son Jesus to save you from your sin. And C, claim Jesus as your Lord and Savior. And then, tell everyone about the good news. Come on, join us in Splash Kingdom.
Yes. So, were you blessed? Yeah. Yes, we're so blessed. So, to our beloved kids, preteens, parents, and volunteers, thank you so much for your wonderful ministry. So, in Kids Church, we do something to appreciate our kids. So, we call it the Amazing Clap. So, it's like this. 1, 2, 3. Amazing. So, can you do it with me? 1, 2, 3. Amazing. Yes. So, thank you so much, our wonderful kids. So, right now, the message is so clear. We have a wonderful Savior, and He wants us to enter into a relationship with Him. He wants us to enter / kingdom. The rich, the poor, the weak, and the strong, Jesus is the living water that saves us. It says in Jeremiah 29:11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope." So God has a wonderful plan for all of us here. Those plans are for our good, for to give us a future, and to give us a hope. So even when we were born, God even laid out a plan of salvation for all of us. It says in Romans 3, verse 23, "For everyone has sinned, and we all fall short of God's glorious standard." So everybody us here is a sinner. Nobody is perfect. And it says earlier that no one is in the no-sin zone, and everyone here needs forgiveness. And you know what? Admitting this fact is very important. It says in Romans 6, verse 23, "For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus our Lord." So sin is powerful. We can see here in this verse the result of sin in our lives. Sin will cause us death. Death in this verse means separation. That means our sins separates us from Him, from having a relationship with Him, from the future that He wants for us. But you know what? It doesn't end here. John 3 verse 16 says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life." Yes, sin is powerful and sin separates us from God's love. But God's love is more powerful. God loved us so much that He gave Jesus to die for us, to pay the penalty of our sins. And when Jesus was there on the cross, He was thinking about you. He was thinking about all of us because He wants our name to be written in the book of life. We don't need to live in sin anymore. We need to believe in Jesus who can turn our lives upside down, and we don't need to live in lies, in deception, in double standards anymore, because Jesus came to give us life and have it to the full. So what do we need to do? It says in Acts 2 verse 38, and Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit." We need to repent and we need to ask for forgiveness. We need to turn away from our sins and turn to God. We need to come to a point of surrender and let Him be the Lord of our lives. And today, you know what? You can decide to believe in Him, decide in His love for you, in the future that He has for you. It says in Romans 10 verse 13, "Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved." Just call on His name. Just call on the name of the Lord. And John 14, 6 says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Jesus is the gate, and you can only enter heaven through Him. Not religion, not the church. It is only by accepting Jesus in your heart that you will be saved. Now, if I may request everybody to please stand up. Here in South, in our branches and campuses, and for those of you who are watching online, my friends, hear this. There is hope in Jesus. Amen. Our lives can be changed by Him, changed for the better, And it says in Hebrews 10 verse 34, you are meant for better things. Things that can last forever. He loves you. He cares for you. He wants to walk with you. Today, He has risen from the dead for you. But the question is, will you let Him in? Will you let Him in your heart and have a relationship with Him? And right now, with every head bowed and every eyes closed, if I am talking to you and you are here right now, or somebody brought you here and you have been attending church for some time now, but you haven't made this decision yet, or you're a visitor, or you have grown cold your relationship with God, if you are here and you want to let Jesus in your heart, kindly raise up your hand. Yes, taas po natin ang ating mga kamay. Yes, for all of our leaders, if you have invites, let's encourage them. And right now, and if you can come forward, yes, and we will pray this prayer of salvation with you. You raise up your hands, and even if you did not,
come on to Jesus.
Encourage them to come forward. Anybody else would want to accept Jesus in your life, we will sing that song once again. Much for making this brave decision. Now, remember, it's just between you and God. Now we will pray this simple prayer of salvation and open your heart to Him. Okay, think as if you're talking to Jesus. And everybody, let's close our eyes and let's join them in this prayer. Repeat after me. Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I come to you.
I come to you.
I know. I have sinned.
I have sinned.
And fell short of your glory. But today, I am coming to you. Asking for forgiveness.
From
all of my sins.
I believe.
You died on the cross. And you rose up again for me. Thank you for loving me.
Today,
I receive you.
In my life.
As my personal Lord.
And Savior.
Lead me, Lord.
Change me.
And help me live.
According to your word.
I open my heart to you.
I give you my life.
From this point forward.
You are the Lord of my life.
I love you, Jesus.
This I pray.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Congratulations, everyone who accepted Jesus in their lives. And heaven is rejoicing. And right now, you receive a Gospel of John. Yeah, so that's just a part of the Bible. And we want to help you grow in your relationship with God. So read that every day. Okay, and you also receive a 4-year card with signature. Yes, so the first box has been signed already because you are present today. Yes, and on your fourth weekend here in church, we will be giving you a whole Bible to help you grow in your relationship with God. All right, so ayan, if you can follow, ayan, the Pastor Jana here in South and there in the campuses and branches, and we want to help you grow more and learn more from your relationship with God. Yes. Close us, may we call on our campus pastors.
Amen. Amen. Are you blessed? Amen. So before we close in prayer, we would like to welcome and acknowledge our first timers here in the house of God. Yes? If you are here and you have questions, our wonderful, happy, and caring pastor will be there at the Livingstone area, and they will be happy to answer all your questions. Livingstone. Yes! Let us give the kids a big round of applause for a wonderful performance. Yes. Amen. Okay, so a few announcements before we close. We would like you to be reminded again, we still have Splash Kingdom Kids Musical this 10 a.m. and 3 p.m. Please bring your loved ones, friends, and those who need Jesus. Amen. Amen. And let us pray. Before that, a few reminder again that we have our morning prayer happening every Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday starting 5 a.m. We encourage you to be here and let the Lord answer all your prayers. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this wonderful day, O God, that you have given us, O Lord God, opportunity to share the gospel through the ministry of these wonderful kids. And we pray, God, that you will continue to use us mightily. Thank you, God, for giving us, O Lord God, the opportunity to be the carrier, the bringer of your message, O Lord God, of the salvation. Thank you, God. And Lord, I lift up everyone to you. We bless them, O God, as they go home. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you. Thank you for coming. See you again next week.